Okay, in this tutorial we're going to talk about how to create control curves for your rig. And what that means is that where you have a bone like this, you'll instead see some kind of custom control curve. To begin, we need to come back out of here and into object mode. And I actually need to do a little bit of setup just to explain how this all works. So I'm going to just go into a new scene, and you can follow along with this if you like. And I'm going to create a bone. So armature, single bone. There we go. Next, I'm going to create a polycurve, which will become the viewport display custom shape of this bone. So as it stands, let's just look at this bone for a moment. If we go over to here, we can see that under the object data properties of this bone, you can decide what viewport display shape you use. So currently the bone is being displayed as an octahedral, but you can change that to stick and it becomes a stick. You can change it to B-bone, it becomes like a rectangle. You can change it to envelope, which is a kind of similar to octahedral really, except it's just a bit more funny looking. And then of course wire, which is just then a curve. So I'll go back to octahedral. It would be good if you could just change the display right here to a custom object, but unfortunately you need to come down here to the bone properties to do that. Under the bone properties you'll see an identical menu called viewport display, except instead of the viewport display menu that you have here underneath the object data properties, this has a whole different set of options, one of which is custom shape. And custom shape is what we're looking for. So we come in here and we find a custom shape that we can use. My list is currently populated because I've got other curves in my other scene, but what we'll use for the demonstration is a circle. So I'm going to go Control A and I'm going to find a circle. There we go, mesh circle. I think I'll just turn on my, right, there we are. I was just turning on the directions down here so you can see what I'm clicking on and when, although it's a little bit obstructed at the moment, so let me just shunt that up a bit and put it there instead. Hopefully that will remain unobstructed as we go through this. So I have a polycircle on the floor and I'm going to tell this bone to take on the appearance of this circle, and I'll do that over here in the bone properties menu by coming to the custom shape and selecting the circle, which is there. Circle. There we go. So now my bone, instead of looking like a wire, instead of looking like a octahedral, it looks like a circle. And you can actually do that with all kinds of objects. So let me just demonstrate with Susan. So if I go to meshes and pull up Susan, there we go, let's put Susan over there. I can select my bone and say to it, look like Susan. And now my bone looks like Susan. It's still a bone, and I can go into pose mode and animate that moving around. So that's how that works. Let's just get out of pose mode and delete Susan. Let's get rid of that. Okay. So we have a circle on the floor and we told this to look like that circle, but there was a strange difference between the two of them. So if I turn that to circle again, notice how my circle's flat on the floor, but this circle is pointing vertically upwards. I've got a horizontal circle on the floor and a vertical circle, which is the bone. Now if I go into the vertex points of this circle, obviously I can change them like this, and you'll see the appearance of the bone changing as well. That means that I can also select these points and move them around. Mm-hmm. But that's not particularly great, it's not very intuitive, it's hard to sort of figure out how and where you might want to place this. So let's just get an example up so that I can demonstrate this properly. I'll create a grease pencil object this time. I'll make Susan again. And we'll put Susan there. And we'll say that this controller is going to be Susan's eye. So if I come into edit mode, get a hold of this bone, take it up here, make it a bit smaller. There we go. Now that's Susan's eye back out here. So conveniently, it's almost in the right place. But wouldn't it be lovely if this curve perfectly went around Susan's eye? Well, no problem. Let's just alter the object. Ah, but the object's still down here on the floor. Let's see how this goes then. So if I click on that object, go to edit mode, I've already got it selected. I'll try moving it. I know I need to scale it, so I'll scale it first, not too bad. Now I need to try to move it upwards. Maybe it's the y-axis then. It is, it's the y-axis. And yeah, it would be nice if it was moved slightly further forward, so I'm guessing that's the z-axis. Yep, it is, it's up and down. There we go. So that's pretty much in the right place. I would describe that as a bit of a shit show. I would describe that as a bit silly and time-consuming. You're playing a lot of guessing games trying to work out where this is and how this is moving around. And so there's a couple of steps that you can take from the get-go to make this a lot more intuitive. And we'll keep Susan where she is so that we're able to continue using her as an example of a character we're trying to rig. So step one is click on your curve as an object. So come up to the items, and as an object, we've got this curve. Rotate it on the X 90 degrees, 90 degrees like that. By doing that, you've aligned the direction of the curve. So as you can see by looking at the two, up is now up, down is now down, left and right are the same. What about forward and back? Forward and back are also the same. So that is one way that you can make it so that this curve and the bone share the same directions. It's still not very easy though. You're still playing a few guessing games because this circle is so much bigger than that circle. Again, in object mode, just shift it up to where it's supposed to be. Scale it so that it's roughly the same size. Now they lay over the top of each other. Go back into vertex mode and start moving it around, and you'll see that they are exactly over the top of each other, sharing the exact space. So once you've made those two adjustments, rotating it 90 degrees on the x-axis, and then in object mode, placing it directly over the top of the bone, this becomes a much more intuitive process where you can precisely line this up the way that you might want it. So that's one way of doing it. Let's talk about the other way of doing it. Right, so the other way to change this is by using the bone rather than the curve on the floor. So with the bone selected, if you come over to the bone properties menu, you can have a look at the same viewport display area that you set your shape. In here you've got some transforms, rotations and scales which you can make use of and change the size and position of the bone, essentially, of the bone's appearance on this rig, which is very handy if you have something like with my tiger where the muscle is being hidden by the head control. Yeah, so being able to scale, translate and rotate the controller is very handy because you can hide things, move things out of the way when they're obstructed or hidden by other objects. So the first thing to note is that the circle is much smaller than the controlling curve that's on the ground, and that's because of the size of the bone. If I made the bone bigger like that, then the control curve would be bigger as well. But you can tell Blender not to take that into account by coming over to the bone properties and just unticking scale to length of bone. By doing that, the display curve takes on the size of the curve that's on the floor. The next thing we'll do is, rather than rotating this curve 90 degrees as we did before, we'll take the bone and we'll rotate that minus 90 degrees on the x-axis, minus 90 degrees on the x. And now that we've done that, again, these two controllers align really nicely in space. So we're getting pretty close now. At this point, there's a couple of options. We could take this curve and just try to roughly position it in object mode over the top of the other one like we did earlier. And, you know, that suffices just fine. Another option is to make the pivot point for this controlling object the same as the pivot point for the bone. So I'll just show you what that looks like now. If I go into edit mode, I've already done this, but I can click on the tail of the bone, press Shift S, and send my 3D cursor to that bone. Now that I've done that, I can come back to object mode, click on my control curve, right click, and set the origin point to the 3D cursor. Watch what happens to the bone when I do this. The bone has just snapped down and is exactly on top of this control curve now. So if I take this control curve and move it around, you'll see that they are indistinguishable, which is a very good place to be, because now that that's like that, I can press rotate X 90 degrees to turn it round, I can then snap to front view, roughly place it, scale it down, and put it where I need it. Excellent. Maybe just move that forward a little bit as well. Remember, this is all in edit mode. So let's move that forward a bit like that. There we go. Great, so now it's a control curve that I can get a hold of. However, there are two things on screen at once here. There's the original curve, and there's the armature. So once you finish this process, you do package away the original curves. You don't delete them, you just package them away in a group somewhere. And I normally just like to call that group controls, like that. And I tend to just take the controls that I've used, drag them and drop them into these little groups. And then I tend to turn on this one here, the disable and viewports, and I just disable them like that, just so they're out of the way, but always there if I need to make any amendments to the shape. So yeah, now I have this curve in pose mode, ready to animate. And that is how creating curves and using them as bone displays works.